Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle video. My name is D-Free. Here today we're going to be talking about what's going on Christmas-wise. So if you guys enjoyed today's video, hit that subscribe. Of course, if you are new, for more content. So we have news on part two. So let's go ahead and start things out. So the first thing to mention here is at the very top, Hercule's heart-pounding gifts. So this is until the 25th. So a lot of this stuff, from what I saw, should be pretty short in length. Like, the Kalen Khalifa banner's coming out. They're here until the 5th. Stuff like that. But yeah, anyways, let's go ahead and start off here, though. But yeah, if you guys are not familiar with what this is just where you log in. You get bonus gifts when Hercule B and Majin Buu show up, ultimately. You get, obviously, it's like an RNG. It's like a separate type of gacha. It's RNG-based. But just for logging in, bonus stuff. Special missions as well. We'll cover the special missions as well here. So here we go. So Xmas Daily missions as well at the top, and we have time limited ones down here. I don't know if I like this like layout. This layout is like, I don't know, seems like super small to me. I don't like it. Bunch of trading items, stones. The Goku Kais are in there too. Other variations of Kais are in there as well, and your awakening medals and stuff like that. Up to 18 dragon stones and 4 Christmas summoning tickets available as well. So there's a bunch of things kind of going on. So in terms of the summons, if you get ultra lucky, you get that reward. Super lucky, you can get either of these. And then just regular lucky. It's just bonus stuff on login, right? Also, for the record, this is getting renewed with the Awakening for Gohan. That's been on JP for a while. So that's pretty much everything in terms of what's on that front page. Let's come back in here, though. So on top of that, though, there is a Dragonstone sale for you whales out there, or you aspiring whales, right? Buy 24 stones at the price of 12 once only. Which is actually probably going to be a really good deal in general. 96 at the price of 32 once only, and then 6 times 91 stone, 20% discount. Okay. Super sale coming through. Not bad. All right. And there's also going to be a buy 5 dragon stones at the price of 1 once per day. Ooh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good for about a week. That one's pretty good. All right. So the next big hitter, the quote-unquote best unit in the game, is finally coming over to Global. LR Kalen Khalifa. We saw this over on the Twitter. I didn't bother reporting on it because I wanted to wait until everything kind of came out, right? So LR Kalen Khalifa are coming over to the global version of the game. They are going to work the same way that they do on JP. They're not going to get nerfed. I saw some people saying they were nerfed or something. It should work the exact same. They're going to be really good, obviously. Again, quote-unquote best unit in the game. You can disagree or not. That's what they're considered by most of the community. Let me know in the comment section down below, though, how hype you are for these guys or ladies coming over to the game. Are you going to summon? Are you not? Also, for the record, like, we're in a really weird spot in terms of global. I've never really been one to advocate, like, or like advise saving, because you get into this loop where you're saving endlessly, right? But do keep in mind that the JP anniversary is in February. So, and presumably it's going to be a Gogeta Blue. If you want that, you might not want to pull here, but realistically, you should have enough time before the global anniversary in the middle of the year, you know. But just keep your eyes open for what happens on the other version of the game, and obviously make the best decision for yourself. It shouldn't matter. You should have enough time. But again, best decision for yourself. Here comes Santa Claus. Special summon. So this time around, we have the Goku, Santa Goku Roshi item available. So there's a summon for that. You guys can summon. I'm assuming it's just going to be, I don't know if it'll be limited or not. A lot of times they tell you if it'll be limited to like 1 or 2 times. We'll find out later tonight, in fact, when the Kalen Khalifa banner goes live. Anyways, this is coming, and it's going to be a summon where you get Goku. It's just Kai's. It's just another Kai banner. All right, so the next Extreme Z Awakening coming to the global version of the game will be, you guessed it, Golden Frieza. Now, we saw that Golden Frieza would be coming because there was a notice on the event for Frieza in the game over the course of the last couple of days anyway. So obviously alongside this, they're going to be dropping the Extreme Z Dokkan Festival and the ticket summons as well over on the global version, as always. And on top of that, they're also dropping the Wicked Bloodline category banner. If you're interested in building that team, if you want more units to fill out the team, definitely go for it, right? Definitely go for it. So all the featured characters are related to the Extreme Z battle, and then also the other banners for the Wicked Bloodline. And then we do have the challenge pack for the tickets and stuff like that. Now, the Extreme Z Awakening event will be dropping again tonight at, what is that, 10:30 it looks like. I'll be in the movie later, but that's when it drops. And then also the Dokkan event for Frieza's live, if you need to do that. It's like always live anyway for the most part, but there it is. All right, so the revamp for this, the renewal for this, in fact, is also going live tonight, too. So, like, everything here is going live literally tonight. It looks like 12:19 across the board, pretty much. So, again, you get that Dokkan Awakenable Gohan into SS2. So that can be good for you if you're trying to farm the super tax of other Gohan cards. Obviously, it'll still be a pretty tedious grind, right? But pretty much all of the youth Super Saiyan Gohans are now farmable in some capacity through that event. And it's nice to see that event getting revamped, because that event, if you guys are not familiar with Global, that event was on repeat for the first during the first year of Dokkan, repeatedly, literally on repeat, repeatedly for months on end. It would come, it would stop. It would come, it would stop. It would come, it would stop. So it's just one of those bad memories I have with this version of the game, because they were doing that and the tournament was coming soon, right? And a lot of you guys probably played back then and you know there was nothing to do. So it's nice to see it's getting a revamp. Speaking of older events that have been on the game for a while, they're reopening all of these events here. The cooler event, and then the other cooler event, and then the PyCon event. So make sure you do go ahead and play those events. PyCon event's still a pretty fun one, because those units are different between that version and this version, the other version and this version. All right. So we have Christmas packs that go live on the 24th. So this is where it looks like things start opening at a later date. Yeah, everything up until here is all coming out tonight. Afterwards, Christmas packs and so on and so forth come out basically on Christmas. So Pilaf's Trove will have premium Christmas tickets. We saw those in Data Mines. They were not live in the game, and they didn't appear that they would be, but they are coming out on the 24th. And of course, alongside those packs, you'll be getting items. It's always nice when there's ticket options available, so they're probably going to be some really good packs. The packs that Pilaf's Trove has had, honestly, Pilaf's Trove had so much criticism upon release, and it's obviously not something for everybody, not everybody can purchase. But if you can, the packs have been really good lately in terms of, like, the value for them. Like, the dual Dokkan Fest Trunks and Zamasu wounds were pretty good. That 20-unit summon for Frieza, like, they've had some really good packs in there. I'm assuming these will be good, too. So, one of the main things everybody was kind of really upset about before Kaioken was announced and in that period, before part one of this pretty much, was, oh, where are my GoBros? Where are my GoBros? They haven't come back yet. Where are my GoBros? Oh, Tanabata Rider, where are they at? Here we go. It looks like the next quote-unquote Tanabata, thank you type of banner, because I was going to say banner, hashtag Tanabata. The next variation of that, though, with the SS4s and Gohan and Goten on there, GoBros, is the Merry Christmas Dokkan Festival. So Merry Christmas Dokkan Festival will also have a ticket summon and a premium ticket summon. So I'm assuming that you get tickets when you do pulls on this banner, because there's two mentions of tickets. And in the premium one, oh yeah, if you look right here, it says premium Christmas and it says Christmas summon ticket. There's probably some sort of like guarantees, different guarantees between them. That's what I'd imagine. But nonetheless, there's going to be two variations of ticket banners, it looks like. Recruit three SSRs, you can be Dokkan Awakened into LRs for your team. So LR Gohan and Goten are coming back alongside the LR SS4s from the anniversary. The following are events that are still available from part one. So part one stuff. So we do have the Full of Wonder Merry Christmas login bonus still going on until the 31st. The Kaioken Goku and Hit event still, Dokkan Festival still going on. And all of this stuff down here from the Universe 6 crossover and stuff like that. So overall though, it's really interesting what they're doing here. Because all of this stuff pretty much ends just after New Year or around the time of New Year. This ends on the 5th, so you have plenty of time. So, like, with everything coming out, you can wait and see what happens. I'm really interested in what they might do for New Year. And I'm just going to inform you guys on a little tidbit. I'd be maybe kind of interested in the idea. Oh, okay. Thanks, Bounty Rush. I'd be interested in the idea of there maybe being more global first stuff. They've obviously always kind of done global first units, and they've been doing them for the last couple of years, but I wouldn't be surprised if there's more of that going forward to make global feel a little bit more special, or maybe even global first events, right? So it's always nice to just have the opportunity and the flexibility to kind of wait and see. And like I mentioned, who knows what's going to happen on the Japanese version of the game too. So you never know if there's going to be any sort of like dual stuff going on between both versions, or like something you might want to save for. Anniversary is soon, but I wouldn't assume that there's another banner dropping for New Year, for the record. Who knows though? Anyways, That is going to do it. Thank you all for tuning in. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Hit that subscribe, of course, if you are new for more content. Let me know if you guys are even going to bother pulling, by the way, on the Dokkan Festival banner that's coming out as well. It's probably going to be really good. Just for the record, it's probably going to be a really good value. So I imagine a lot of you guys probably will. SS4s are on there, of course. Wait, for the record, though, I don't remember the last time I bought a banner. Let me know in the comments if last time around it was these three and the older two Dokkan Fest LRs. I don't recall, though. Let me know. And it's obviously not listed as Tanabata, but same type of deal. Maybe I'm confusing it for a separate banner. So many banners have happened. Anyways, thank you all, and I'll catch all of you in the next one.